Hi, welcome to the course on scaling and accelerating your machine learning pipeline. Now, if you go by the name, there are two parts to the course. One is how can you scale your machine learning pipeline? And second is how you can accelerate your machine learning pipeline. In the scaling part, we are going to talk about how to build your models or machine learning pipeline, starting from data collection, data engineering, and even on model deployment, when your data is pretty large to fit on a single node. So basically, we'll be talking about distributed computing, building machine learning using distributed computing. And also, we'll be talking about how we can accelerate the machine learning and data analysis journey on hardware accelerators like GPUs and TPUs. In the accelerating part, we are going to purely talk about how you can generate your hypothesis faster, how you can generate your insights faster that can help achieve faster business value in an organization. So we are going to talk about frameworks that can hard automate part of your machine learning lifecycle journey. This course is geared for data architects. That will be like a sufficient substance where we'll be talking about data architecture on different cloud platform. It is for machine learning engineers to learn tools and techniques that can enable distributed machine learning training. This is for data engineers where which will help data engineers build a robust and scalable pipeline. And finally, it is also for software engineers where they can take the model and deploy the model in a pretty scalable environment for real-time streaming analytics, as well as where the volume, basically the number of scoring instances need to be pretty fast and need to be kind of in high velocity, right? The course is spread across 6 different modules. In the first module, we'll be talking about Apache Spark. We will give an overview of Apache Spark. We will talk about data engineering using Apache Spark, machine learning using Apache Spark. We'll also cover time series analysis and deep learning using Apache Spark. The second module is purely focused on TensorFlow, where we'll be talking about some of the advanced concepts of TensorFlow. And also we will be talking about how to accelerate your TensorFlow model journey on GPU and TPU. And finally, we will end the session with how you can build a scalable data analysis pipeline using TensorFlow and the TFX extension. The third module is about scaling XGBoost using Rapids, which is a new framework that is coming up to scale your machine learning pipelines on GPUs. It is a replica of scikit-learn. And then we will be also talking about Numba, which is a framework that can accelerate your Python functions. So that is going to be the third module. The fourth module, we are going to purely focus on cloud for data and AI. We are going to talk about cloud reference architectures. We are going to talk about cloud in the context of AWS SageMaker, machine learning in the context of Google AI platform, or it can be Azure ML. So that is going to be the fourth module, purely focused on cloud. It's for data engineering, data analysis, as well as machine learning building. In the fifth part, we'll be focusing on Auto ML. So one of the thing I mentioned is accelerating your machine learning pipeline, like how you can accelerate your machine learning pipeline that you can generate faster value. So we'll be talking about various Auto ML frameworks that are available today that can help you accelerate your model development journey as well as your hyperparameter selection journey. So we'll be talking about multiple Auto ML frameworks over there. In the final part, we'll be talking about model deployment. This is going to be purely focused on high velocity, high volume model scoring environment where we will take the model and deploy it in an auto scaling framework, right? We are going to talk about Docker and Kubernetes for data science. We will go to cloud platform and see how we can deploy it on a cloud platform. So it's going to be completely hands-on. You can take this, you can see the video, go and practice by yourself. I'll also give tips on how you can spin up an environment and use it for free for your learning purpose. So that's the entire 6 module course that we'll be covering. You can see more details about the course FAQs in the video description below, where I have attached link to a detailed course curriculum and for frequently asked questions that may come up. You can basically see the details over there. At the same time, some of the contents of this course are already available in my YouTube channel. But over the time, I'll be building the remaining content. The time currently I have is by July, I should have all the content up and ready for this particular course. But I'll be frequently publishing the content and then notifying you. The best way to get notified about my the content in for this course is subscribe to my channel, AI Engineering. And also like press the bell button to get notified next to the subscribe channel. The prerequisite for this course is you need to for some of the modules you need to have Python knowledge and some basic understanding of machine learning. You need to understand how an end-to-end machine learning pipeline works. If you have not seen my previous video on end-to-end machine learning, basically you can click on the link that comes in the top and you can watch it. That's kind of a prerequisite. It will be a quick 20 minutes video that will give you an overview of end-to-end machine learning cycle. And for some of the course, there is no knowledge of Python required or understanding of machine learning. If you're a data engineer, you can directly understand the data architecture on various cloud platform. So this is going to be about the course. Do stay tuned and please be patient. Like rather than reaching out to me, I have in the link that I have published, I have mentioned and timeline by the videos will be out. I will try to keep up with the timeline as much as possible. But if not, I will come up with an alternate date as well. So please read through the document and then only reach out to me if you have any specific questions. The best way to get your queries answered is to use the YouTube comment section for each video, so that if even I am not able to answer, somebody who is watching the video and who is knowledgeable can answer your questions. Thank you.